بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم الله رب محمد صلى عليه وسلم نحن عباد محمد صلى عليه وسلم. But the Muslims, the times we live in, unfortunately the Muslims, they are diverting away from the way of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. They are diverting away from Islam and the teachings of Islam. And they have adopted many such actions which are totally against Islam and which lead towards Jahannam, hellfire. And from those many actions which we should not have adopted and which are not the attributes of a believer, what we have taken and adopted is that we have adopted lying and we have left and diverted away from sidq, speaking the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu attaqullah, that O you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa kunu ma'as sadiqeen, and you know, be with the sadiqeen, the ones who speak the truth, meaning that, you know, affiliate yourselves with them and be part of them and be the ones who speak the truth. So speaking the truth is something really important in Islam and is haram to lie. And there are many narrations of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding lying and, you know, the effects of it. And, you know, how the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us that the person who lies, he's like a hypocrite and the abode for him is hellfire. So we won't talk about that today, but I would like to talk about speaking the truth. You know, we should always try to speak the truth. Of course, sometimes, you know, they say that truth, sidq, sometimes might be bitter. Yes, in Umar radiallahu anhu, he used to say that always speak the truth, even though it might be bitter. It might be that, you know, often they say that truth hurts people, but your job is to speak the truth. And, you know, we should stay away from lying and we should always try to adopt, you know, this way of Islam and this teaching of Islam, and we should always, always speak the truth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran that be with the ones who are sadiqeen, and, you know, you should be a sadiq yourself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the greatness of the people who speak the truth. I would like to mention one hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, though. Is narrated by Sayyidina Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. He says that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, alaykum bis sidq, that it is incumbent that you speak the truth. It is necessary that you speak the truth. It's really important and you must speak the truth. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ. Why? Because sidq, it leads towards good. It guides you towards good. And then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَإِنَّ الْبِرَّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And if you good, leads you towards paradise. So if a person speaks the truth, then that leads him towards righteousness, leads towards good. And if a person is good, he is righteous, then righteousness leads to paradise. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that مَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ يَسْتُكُ وَيَتَحَرَّ الصِّدْقَ حَتَّى يُكْتَبُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ صِدِّيقًا. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that a person, he continues to be truthful. And then he encourages honesty as well. So if a person is always truthful, he's always speaking the truth, and he encourages people to speak the truth as well, then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there'll be a time that yuktabu inda Allah siddiq, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he'll be written as a siddiq. Allahu Akbar. You know, if you look at the Quran, in juz, the fifth juz of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that an'am Allahu alayhim minan nabiyyina wa siddiqeen wa shuhada'i wa salihin. So the grades of, you know, the stations are, the ranks are, that the anbiya alayhimus salam, they are at the top. The rank after that is the rank of the Siddiqeen. So a person now, he's always speaking the truth, he's encouraging truth, he's encouraging people to be honest, and he's always honest himself, Now there'll be a time that in the court of Allah, in the sight of Allah, he'll be written as Siddiq. Allahu Akbar. So there's nothing greater than this now. A person, of course, our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the last prophet of Allah. Nobody can be a Nabi now. But to attain this great rank, the highest rank you can attain today is Siddiq. So now if a person is always speaking the truth, a person is always encouraging honesty, and he's always telling people to speak the truth, and he's always standing by the side of Haq, truth, then what will happen is that the benefit for this will be that he'll be given the rank of a Siddiq, the highest rank you can attain today. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Asr, the Wal Asr, by time, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ, that indeed insan, mankind is in loss. But إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمُنُوا, but the ones who believe, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and the ones who have righteous actions, righteous deeds, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ, and the ones who encourage Haq, truth, honesty, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ, and the ones who encourage patience. So now, all of mankind is in loss until you believe. Then once you believe, you are, you know, coming towards righteousness, then your actions are good, so perfect. But then once you encourage, so when you know encouraging haq and encouraging sabr, so encouraging honesty and truth and encouraging sabr, patience, it does not mean that you only tell other people, but you need to of course adopt that first. So a person adopts truthfulness, a person, he adopts honesty, and then he encourages that, then that person, he's not never in loss. So Allah says that in the Quran. So all the mankind is in loss, but for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made four exceptions. So one of the exceptions is that a person who believes and he has good actions, and then at the same time, what does he do? He encourages the truth and honesty. So that person, he will be at that rank. So if you're always speaking the truth, if you're always encouraging honesty, if you're always encouraging people to speak the truth, then you'll be known as Siddiq in the rank of Allah, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the highest rank one can attain. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَالْكَذِبِ, and you know, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, beware of falsehood, beware of lying. Why? Because فَإِنَّ الْكَذِبَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْفُجُورِ. Why? Because falsehood, it leads towards fisk and fujur, meaning it leads towards bad. And then وَإِنَّ الْفُجُورَ يَهْدِي إِلَى النَّارِ, and fujur, bad, wickedness, it leads towards hellfire. And then وَمَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ يَكْذِبُ وَيَتَحَرَّ الْكَذِبُ حَتَّى يُكْتَبُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَذَّابًا. Now a person, he does not speak, he does not always lie, and a person, you know, he until he encourages lies. So a person who is lying, a person who is encouraging people to lie, you know, often you do find within friends that one friend might be the best liar. Yeah, he knows how to make up excuses. Yeah, that person, to be honest, you know, he's fooled under this. So a person who's always lying, he's always, you know, making up excuses, false, you know, excuses, and then he's always encouraging people to lie, then that person now, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he'll be recorded as kathab, the big liar. Yeah, so you can imagine if Siddiq is the greatest rank, then the opposite to that is kathab. So that's the worst a person can be. So let's always be honest. Let's always speak the truth. Why? Because this truth will lead you towards righteousness. It'll lead you towards good. And once you are righteous, once you are good, what will happen? You'll attain paradise. You'll enter paradise. Likewise, the opposite, if you're lying, if you're always encouraging lying, and, you know, lying takes you to bad, it makes you a bad person. Because obviously, you'll see that once you start to lie, there are many, you know, side effects of that. Yeah, you'll become a person whose shame will go away. Yeah, a person, his taqwa, his fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will go away. Yeah, a person, his spirituality will be gone. And then he will become immodest. Once haya leaves, your iman is gone. So lying, there are many, you know, it's the root to many, many, many other sins. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that make sure that you are a sadiq, the one who speaks the truth. That will make you righteous, and righteousness will take you to paradise. And make sure that you protect yourself from falsehoods and lying. Why? Because that leads you towards bad. And if you're bad, then that will take you to hellfire. And if you're speaking the truth, you'll be literally a Siddiq. the highest rank. And if you're always lying, you'll be literally kazzab, the worst ever. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to always speak the truth, to always be honest, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, our families, and all the Muslims from lying. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to follow the way of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen. Bijahin Nabil Ameen sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallam.